Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video I'm going to talk about how to draw and construct these flags or banners or even treasure maps. These shapes you could also use for a flip page. Let's get started. I'm going to move this to the side and let's take the pencil tool. And what we need to do is draw the upside view of this one. So that would be like this, maybe like so, and there we have another curve, like so. Let's apply a stroke to that, and then let's distort it slightly so it looks like shown from the side. And then we're going to make a copy, just press the Alt key and drag it down. And that one we could distort slightly more to make it look like so. You could also use the perspective grid for that to make a true perspective view of this. But for this purpose, that's okay. Now what we need to do is find the tangents, the lines that connect these. And that's kind of the difficult part of this. I need to zoom in a bit and delete this anchor point, like so. And what could be easy is the left and rightmost, because then you could just draw a vertical line and then align them to the left. But that won't help you with the middle ones. So let's delete this one. And in order to do that, you have two choices. So one of them is to use a script. I'm going to select both of them and then let's get to the script. Let's go to File, Scripts and Other Scripts. And I've got it on my desktop already. And it's this one, Common Tangents. I have the link to the script in the comments of this video. Just open it, let it run, and it will connect all the common tangents in these shapes, which are a lot. So we need to delete a lot. Let's start with these and just get rid of them. Of course, we need to take care that we don't delete those we need. So we need the vertical ones and just delete all the other ones, like so. There we go. All these we need to get rid of and just keep the ones that we need. Like so. And that's it. And we need to connect these and these, and there's our base shape. Now, in order to get to the shapes we need, we can use the Live Paint Bucket tool. And let's set the stroke to none. To set the stroke to none, I have changed tools and get to the selection tool, set them to none, select the Live Paint Bucket tool, and now we need to build shapes. So just select any color and then color them and make sure you get the shapes you need. So select a different color and then let's see what we need here, like so, and on the other side as well, like so, and yet another color, get some lighter colors, so like so, and here as well. And then the next color and get these and yet another color like so, and another one and like so. So these would be the shapes we need in order to be able to fill this with gradients. Now we could fill the gradients into this Live paint group, but gradients and live paint groups don't work too well. So what we can do is expand this, and then we still have, as you see, single shapes. So in order to connect them, we go to Window and then Pathfinder and click on Merge. And this could be filled with gradients, like so. Now let's get to the next option we have to create these, and I have this one for it. And in the layers panel, you see I have already drawn it. So I have the base shapes, and in order to get common tangents here, I'm going to use a plugin, which is the plugin Subscribe. And again, the link is in the comments. So let's get to the tangent line tool. And let's see, and you see it shows a lot of points. So let's drag from here to there. And there we get our tangents, like so. So it can't get any simpler than this. And you do this, build your tangents, and when you're done with that, again, you need live paint to actually draw them. So that's how you can build these banners and flags. And if we take a look at the outline view, then you see there we have all these lines, and they are pretty exact. And we can then use that. So that's how it goes. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.